Okay, hello everybody. So warm welcome also from our side. So let me just briefly introduce myself, Andreas Kegraf. I'm here you see the title cross-functional epic owner, but this is essentially a solution manager for the ETAS ADAS solutions. Stefan.
Yeah. Thanks, Andrea. So also a warm welcome from my side. My name is Stefan Krasin. I'm the CEO of PLC2, and I'm really happy to present you today our latest achievements on technology.
So you might ask yourself why we both from ETAS and PLC2 are here in this session presenting you our solution. And this is because we are really, really closely collaborating here in this area. To give you solutions that are really complete. And we will focus on one part here, the logging part, which we'll see now in the following. Stefan, do you want to say something to the agenda?
So, yeah, okay. So what we would like to start, with an introduction around which kind of challenges do we face in the ADDA market, so for automated driving and the advanced driver assistance system market in general. What are the challenges now, also with existing solutions for metrologies and also replay system? We have the answer for you. We have the solution together, ETAS and PLC2. We provide the next generation logging solution. It's a current turnkey solution for the entire needs in future development system. Then we would like to end up our presentation with a live demo where we would like to show you our innovative data logger. Now, in that case, specifically use case for the video measurement and metrology solution with a lot of USPs. Stay tuned.
Okay, so then we start really here with a high-level overview about the challenges that we see in the ADDA market. And of course, based on these challenges, we also design our solution. So we think we present that in the beginning for you. And let's really start high-level. Let's have a look really at the ADAS market, not very much in detail, but there are some assumptions here, of course, from our side. So what we see in the market and what guides us also in the direction of developing solutions is that we see fusion and perception, that means video, LiDAR, radar, and also others, in the future will be more and more executed on the domain controller ECU, so what we call the ADCU, the autonomous driving ECU. But we see here that there are really changes happening in the market in the future. Also, what we see that the internal data from the ECU and also the raw data, both together, this will be needed in the future. So probably today, there's still a bit of separation, but in the future, this will be needed. And that, of course, influences our solution also. And there is one very important thing, the data rates. Yeah, so the high performance data logging is definitely required. This is what we see at the moment already at our customers. And this is also what this session will be about. Yeah. So we see actually in the market that we see a lot of evidence for these hypotheses I just presented to you. So without going too much into detail, but that's a very recent McKinsey study that you can see here. So what do you see? First of all, that, of course, the autonomous driving systems and especially hardware, the market is growing, of course. That's interesting then for us also. But I think what you see also, and that's quite interesting, and that's also where we base our solution onto, is that the part of the ADCU, so the domain controller ECU, that part is growing significantly. Yeah? So if you look at 2030, this is also a prediction of McKinsey, and we see it the same way, that you have definitely radar, but also besides radar, LiDAR, and video taking an important role. But if you have a look at the black part, so the domain controller, you see this is really a significant part. So recording this data in an homogeneous and synchronized way, That is what we think will be key, and this is what we are actually working, and we can provide solutions for this point. Good. Let's have a look a bit more into the details. So what are the challenges in the market? So what are the challenges that we see at our customers? You see already this nice picture. So data is definitely an important point, time synchronization, and you see also what we observed, the metrology or the measurement system is not so easy as probably in recent times in powertrain. So this all is getting very complex. So what does it mean in detail? Let's first of all probably have a bit of look at the data. So the data is needed definitely for various purposes. Yeah, so function development, training, and also of course for validation. So I think here an important point is what we see on the market, that there is a close connection required. So seamless integration between the measurement system on one side and also, of course, on the validation system. So that would be a recompute system typically on the other side. So here key is really that the data fits together nicely. And we hear a bit more about that later. Okay, so the data is coming from multiple sensors. I mentioned that already before. Plus, of course, the data is not only coming from this, the data is also coming from the ECUs. That all together makes the challenge to store this data so in a good way. Of course, the high data rates is a big challenge. We see that the amount has increased recently. So we're at several tenths of gigabit per second at the moment, going up to 100 and will be potentially more in the future. So this is what we see when all the data needs to be recorded. This all is a requirement from our customers, and there we need to find an answer, and we'll present you an answer later. Of course, storing a high amount of data causes costs. We know that. We are very much aware of this. So our customers also require means against this. Just collecting all the data is not sufficient. So there need to be somehow intelligent means, and we'll come back to that also a bit later. Data integrity, I mentioned that already before. Data integrity is important. So meaning that you cannot afford, of course, we know that you cannot afford just to lose some part of data. You cannot afford asynchronous data. You need to have all the data you require, and that with a very high precision. So we are aware of that, and our solution really is based on fulfilling this requirement. Yeah, the costs, looking at the test fleet, there we see also a big challenge for the costs of the test fleet, which are really high. So the test vehicles with the complete equipment, they cost a lot. And of course, therefore, an availability of these test vehicles is really required. If the test vehicles are just not ready to be used, this is not an option for our customers. And of course, the reliability of the measurement system is really key. This is what we see. Just a bit more to the technical points. I mentioned that before, because the system, the measurement system is really complex. There, the available space in the trunk where the measurement system is located. This is also a challenge. Well, in a car, there is only a limited amount of space. And so a measurement system from our side should take very little space in this. And you see in a moment how we encompass this challenge. Of course, power consumption is the same. Just 1 or 2 kilowatts is probably not a good idea if you have a lot of vehicles. This is a potential danger also for the operation of the test vehicles. And of course, I mentioned that before, the complexity of the measurement here has grown a lot if you compare it to recent times with powertrain metrology. So here, the measurement system is very complex, and that imposes also new challenges. Okay, let's have a short look at the use cases over the course of the project. So what we want to show you here is a very, very simplified project setup. So of course, the project starts, you have several samples with every time more maturity until the start of production as the final step. So that's the typical course of a project that we see. Now, what we see is probably not everything, not all the use cases and not all the requirements are very homogeneous distributed over the course of the project. We see also that there are different phases. And to make it simple, what we see is here, typically we see at our customers' ramp-up phase, with slightly different use cases than probably in the later course of the project. So in the ramp-up phase, you typically have an ECU with little functionality, and that ECU is typically implemented as a high-performance PC because you're really in an early phase of the project. You take typically sensors from previous projects. So everything has to be a bit, let's say, just a bit improvised also and put together from different pieces. So also the measurement equipment needs to fit to this, let's say, very flexible system. So in the beginning, we think a very flexible measurement system is really key. Yeah? So that imposes specific challenges to the first part. And here we see, of course, at the moment that many of our customers are in this phase in many projects. But we see also in later stages of the project, we call this year the project execution, it is important also to have the right measurement equipment available, because in this phase, the measurement data is needed really and needs to be collected for more also for validation and homologation. So not only for the function development, but also for these other purposes. And the use of the test vehicles, that's the efficient use of the test vehicles is really key here. Yeah? So you have test drivers with tight schedules, and they need to capture the necessary data. So you need to be quite sure that you capture also this data in these test phases. So capturing the relevant data, this is what I mentioned before. So probably not all the data, but really the relevant data, this is key. So we see here a bit of shift between really the most flexible system that's there in the beginning. You need to have a bit of shift in the direction of a more reliable system, which you need in the later project phases. So we focus our development really also very much on reliability, because we think this is really key. Yeah? Even if we see a lot of customers who just started their projects, they want to be flexible. Yeah? But we anticipate also from other projects that we have had that more in later phases of the projects, this reliability is really an important factor for the measurement system. Okay, so let's here again have a bit of look at the challenges in these different phases. I mean, that's just a short summary, but as I mentioned before, in this ramp up phase, yeah, so you need, of course, a fast and flexible logging system. You need to be capable of emulating some part of the ECU functionality, which is typically still not there in these early project phases. You need to monitor the measurement systems and the sensor data very closely in order to be able. So you're building up essentially the measurement system itself, and you need to be able to monitor it. Yeah. So it's the two things, building up the complete system and building up the measurement system. So this is some specific challenge here. So what we see here is our recommended solution approach is typically a PC. While we see that our customers are using high-performance PCs, but we see here, for instance, with specific acceleration cards, which we have in our portfolio, things are becoming easier. Yeah? So high-performance PCs are really quite difficult to handle. They're expensive and they're difficult to handle typically. And so we offer something here that makes the use of the PCs easier, probably allows you to change also from high-performance PCs to mid-performance PCs. So that's how we would recommend the first solution approach. And looking at the later phases, this is what I just mentioned before, there the challenges change a bit, or you have additional challenges which mainly go in this direction of the reliability. First thing, which is really important, you need to assure data integrity. So you will typically, you do not want that the test vehicles are driving all day. In the end, you realize that the data is not really good. You cannot use it because some part of the data is missing, or the wrong data was recorded, or the data is just not synchronized. Everything of these issues you would like to avoid, of course. The second point is the power consumption, very important factor. What we see, 1 or 2 kilowatts is just a lot and something that typically our customers would like to avoid. And of course, you would like to have very, very much automated processes. Yeah. So while in the first phase, in the ramp up phase, you're still building up the system and more flexibility is required. In the second or later phases, the automation is really an important factor here to build up an efficient metrology on measurement system. So what we see here is, or what we recommend here, is of course a solution approach, a direction we are taking that Stefan's going to explain just now. I hand over to Stefan to the next generation logging.
Yeah, thank you, Andreas. Thanks a lot. So one remark here. So please do not hesitate to ask any questions in the Q&A pane here, in the chat window there over there. We are really happy then later on to answer your questions. So I would like to follow up here on that side. So Andreas made the introduction, also explained about current challenges on that side. And we have seen that also with our past experience over the last 10 years, what are really the challenges with a lot of hands-on experience during a lot of T1 OEM projects. And we have collected a lot of requirements and talked to customers and approached the market as well, where we then said, okay, hey, we need to find a way out there, need to also face challenges in the future and provide an optimal product. So let me take over the control. So for the future. And I would like now to introduce you to our latest achievement. Its name is the ADL 1000 series. So it's a very high speed, low power, compact data logger. As you can see, it is a very compact one, as already said. In the front, we have all the connections. We have a lot of air-cooled solution. We have an air-cooled solution, as you see, and a lot of housekeeping connections, power, and so forth. Meaning what we were focusing on, very compact one, very easily to access, also in the trunk, where we have all interfaces directly in the front. So let me give you some more technical details here. We offer an logging and the playback solution all in one with a bandwidth of up to 128 gigabits per second. That means 16 gigabytes per second of logging and playback bandwidth. We have a lot of also on-site memory besides some dynamic DDR technology based memory. We do also offer U2 NVMe based storage devices where we can handle of up to 128 terabyte NVMe storage capacity. Of course, that's the current limitation of existing NVMe technologies, but in future there might be some more available. But what we can see also in the picture is that we have in total eight slots connected. Eight slots available for U2 NVMe memory blocks. We do offer also dynamic memory, as already mentioned, of a memory size of up to 258 gigabyte DDR4 memory to temporarily buffer data, pre-processing data, manipulating data, and analyzing data in real time. So we have a quite compact size, fits in a 19-inch rack. We use three units in total the size, and you see also the dimensions in the brackets and in millimeters as well. It is the ADL 1000 is fully air-cooled with an very innovative mechanical concept and temperature concept here inside. We have a lot of different kind of debug ports. We do have also extension capabilities with a lot of also high voltage range GPIOs. What we do also have an onboard bot management controller, and this bot management controller is controlling the overall voltages of the PCB and monitoring the temperature in the chassis, and also monitoring with a lot of available sensors on the PCB, built on the PCB directly, measuring the temperature of that box and of that overall system. We have also remote access, where we can build in our AD1000 into a kind of fleet management, make that available as a node in the overall fleet. We have capabilities for status and configuration interfaces as well, integration into, and of course, the full integration into the ETAS entire solution and the framework around their Railo solution. So now let's talk a little bit more about the use case in general. As you have seen, the ADL1000 is a dedicated Ethernet-based logger. Let me use the laser pointer. It's the fully Ethernet-based logger with a QSFP plus connectors, with QSFP 28 connectors, 200 gigabits of them, where we we're focusing on, as I said, the Ethernet connection. And what we see here is we build up an Ethernet network in general. So we have several probes. Let's start from the left side, several sensors with several kind of data. Could be either video data, which is one of the most has one of the most bandwidth needs in general. We have LiDARs, we have radar data, we can have multiple other ones, or also low speed, like CAN, FlexRay, and so forth. But as Andreas already mentioned before, we can have, or we do have, and there is a need for a lot of, also in future, more and more internal ECU data coming. And this is where ETAS is offering a probe called the GTK as well, using internal or receiving internal ECU data and forwarding those kind of probes. They convert that to the Ethernet network in general, and we are capable of receiving all the data over the Ethernet network directly with the ADL. Thanks to our FPGA technology, it's a hybrid solution internally in the ADL. Thanks to our FPGA technology, where we are really flexible in implementing several kind of protocols, handling for probing several kind of video data, and also being flexible in a kind of pre-processing and acceleration as well. So currently we do offer protocol handling, as already written here, like the CMP protocol, VG Vision, UDP, and we do also offer custom protocol implementation if needed by the customer and the project. One remark here, as you can see here, is written a kind of L5. L5 is our lossless video compression FPGA IP core. What we can do is FPGA accelerated lossless video compression and decompression, where we have compression rates of up to 70% in general, meaning on the one side we can reduce bandwidth on the line, but also at the end, what is the main use case, we can reduce the memory storage need, meaning less memory or longer recording times. And we can offer that both either on the probe side. Here there is written an MHD. This is also the ETAS probe for the video recording as well, where we can then directly on the MHD, probe, use our FPGA-based lossless compression for compressing the video data here, but also on the ADL side, where we can compress that as well and then store compressed data on the memory devices directly on the NVMe memories. We do offer also software decompression libraries for the ingest, then later on for the readout of the data. And we do also offer decompression on FPGA, meaning again, hardware accelerated for the replay purpose. So that means the ADL is on the one side capable of recording all the data, storing that to the memory, and then also make that available to the ingest station as well. Either could be upstream by 100 gig, by 100 gigabit per second link over Ethernet directly, or it can be stored on the local U2 NVMe memory blocks devices, which can be then plugged out and plugged in directly to the ingest station again. So there's no further way needed for that, you know, to get the data out. But we do also offer replay capabilities in one box, besides the recording, where we can then playback the bundled data directly in over the Ethernet network, and sending that then directly to over to the ECU for replay purposes as well. Okay, let's have a look about on the key features of our ADL 1000. As already mentioned, it's an FPGA based data logger with CPU capabilities and also GPU extensions as well. So we were focusing on facing the challenges which were mentioned by Andreas before. So meaning our key features of the ADL are, we are robust, we have a reliable data integrity. So data losses are really important for us, that they do not appear. We are a low power FPGA based data logger. We have a power consumption of maximum 250 watts. And we have high bandwidth data recording, as already mentioned. So we have an all in one solution for recording and replay, as seen before. And in replay, it is possible also to play back the distribution, or to play back distributed data of before bundle data, which were recorded and pre-sorted before. We do offer also custom protocol termination, thanks again to the FPGA technology, where we can be really very flexible, modular, and also extendable to the project needs as well. We do, through the real-time processing in the FPGA, we avoid the demand for real-time processing in the software. So that means we avoid the challenges to use a real-time operating system, based also on our experience over the year, struggling with data losses. On a CPU-based data logger is a really big challenge, and also takes a lot of time also to figure that out and get a stable system as well. Time synchronization as well is also really important between the different kind of data streams from the different kind of data sensors on both sides, where we offer IEEE based time synchronization as well. The lossless video compression and decompression of a compression rate of an average 60% is also offered in our ADL, either for the recording, compressing the data, but also then for the replay, where we can decompress the data, which then will be forwarded and to the ECU directly. We have also remote accesses available, then also configuration, and also interfaces for updates for the configuration management, which is also important in an overall solution, measurement solution, and replay system, where we can also handle the different kind of configurations based on the current use case and the current system setup as well. We do have also diagnostics interfaces where we can show in real time Are the interfaces alive? Which probes are active? We can control the different kind of probes. We can get status information about bandwidth. We can get status information about the data integrity and so forth. Yeah, and as briefly mentioned, in general, the ADL 1000 can be seen as an innovative edge accelerator, thanks to hardware acceleration and also the combination and extension of a GPU-based system as well, where we can then also run AI-based models and applications for real-time analyzing of the data, but later more. So what are your benefits? What are the customer benefits here? We say, hey, with our ADL, you can use any sensor and any data, and you bring that into one system. So you have seen the complex trunk with a lot of different kind of hardware models and blocks and kind of individual solutions. Also, maybe sending out their proprietary protocols. And how can you handle all those? Yeah, with our ADL, it's possible. Just connect all the sensors with the probes and any data within one system. Also, a huge advantage for you is the seamless integration in general of such complex requirements and such complex projects and such complex systems as well. The seamless integration now also with the current and future ETAS products as well, where ETAS can offer a full and entire turnkey solution for you for the metrology applications. We also do a direct stream. So the direct streams of the probes from the different sensors will be in real time, then also pre-sorted, and as already mentioned, compressed. Of course, could be lossless, but also lossy, you know, in some situations as well, where we store them directly to the memory and can be then afterwards used directly and brought to the Inga station. So there is also, again, one step less needed for getting the data out, minimum one step. So data integrity is one of also the most challenging scenarios, as I already mentioned, with the requirements for real-time operating system, CPU-based real-time operating system, and data integrity is, from our side, guaranteed by hardware-accelerated checksum calculations set. So that means in real-time, we check data by checksums as well on the FPGA technology and ensure data integrity. We were focusing on the ADL, having an offering also a modular and an open based system as well, based on standard solutions. So meaning we there was no idea about starting and implementing some proprietary protocols and some proprietary interfaces and solutions like that. No, we were focusing on standardized solutions. As you have seen, your two NVMe memories as well, also CMP protocols, also based on the Ethernet network in general, and also different kind of data formats as well. So on our ADL, there's also running in Linux OS with options for running ROS, the ROS operating system, ROS 2 operating system, where we as PLC2 work very closely together also with the FPGA SoC vendors as well, where we can accelerate several ROS layers in real time in the FPGA before as kind of ROS kernels. And we do offer then also ROS interfaces and ROS solutions then on the software side for the overall integration. So data encryption for sure is also possible also on FPGA side. That means we offload also a lot of CPU calculation or CPU utilization and bring that in FPGA, make pre-processing as well to offload a lot of CPU power. Yeah, and in general, the FPGA technology is for you also or for customer needs also available to implement specific solutions, specific interfaces, and also specific algorithms and kind of pre-processing of the data. For example, on the video path, if there are some color reconstructions needed, or also we do some image size scaling for hardware accelerated, and then can make the pre-processed data available later on, then also to the further stages in the process of the data, in the processing of the data. Okay. All right. So now I would like to hand over to my colleague Berkay. He would like to show you a live demo. The live demo can be shown, can be seen here. It's a block diagram. We have that live demo here available in our room, in my bag as well, where you will see hopefully me then later on through the cameras. I'm getting recorded here. So what can we see here? How is the setup of the live demo of the how is the demo setup built? So on our ADL, there is a remote control PC connected over 1 gigabit Ethernet connection where Berkay has access to over that. He will share his screen soon. And in this demo, we would like to show you the video path journal where we have the MHD2 connected, the ETAS MHD2, which is the video probe. Several kind of imagers connected on 8 megapixel imagers, also 3 megapixel imagers connected to the MHD probe directly. And this MHD probe is connected over 2 gigabit Ethernet interfaces to the ADL. And we would like now to show you also the live recording of the data, proof data integrity, and also show you then, at the end, the recording path is stable and working really reliable. Okay, so Berkay, stage is yours. Are you there?
Yes. Hi, Stefan. This is Berkay from PS2. I will, as Stefan mentioned, I would like to shortly demonstrate the capabilities of our ADL 1000. And in this demo, we will use the video input pad. As you see, we have a connection to ADL. Through SSH, and I will run the application for recording through the SSH on ADL. And on the second terminal, I will show you the CPU and other resource consumptions while we are running this demonstration. And the low terminal is used for the visualization, where we will run we will serve the images recording from ADL, and we will run a GUI application where we can visualize the images and we can check the metadata for the images. I start the recording. This would start the recording on the MHD site and would start the recording on the ADL. Here you can see we are checking the received block of images. We are checking if the inside the blocks, we are checking then the metadata for any invalid images. Then we are checking the validity of the images we receive. And here you can see we are receiving at 6.6 gigabit per second from each 10 gigabit link. And you can also see the disk utilization. And when we start the recording, all the data is written on an NVMe SSD, and we have the database created with the all the metadata which we would need for the later extraction. Okay, and in the second phase of the demo, we would serve these images through a REST API over 1 gigabit Ethernet. And this would trigger the REST API on the system. And down here, I will start the GUI application. It's so 1 gigabit Ethernet, and you can see we can find the sessions, recording sessions here. And when we click, we see that two interfaces are inside this session, two 10 gigabit interfaces. And when I open the interfaces, we see the blocks, data blocks. And inside each data block, we are having four images. And if I click on one block, you can see that my colleagues over there doing the streaming, and we have then four camera input. And if I go to interface two, it's also the similar. We have four camera inputs, but as we had only two physical cameras, you see then three the same images, and the third one is different. And these three images are 8 megapixels. You can find the resolution here, and you can see that CRC is okay. This CRC is compared, calculated, and compared with the CRC inside the metadata. And we can be sure that the data integrity is completely okay. And here you see that the third 3 megapixel camera on the third slot. And we can go through the images, but there are some changes inside that you can see that the live streaming and other than that, that's basically the demonstration we have prepared with the MHD. But as Stefan mentioned, it is possible to record through the other props over ADL. But it is easier to demonstrate with the video part, the data. If there are any questions, I would like to answer them.
Yeah, so they will come up. Then also, thanks, Berkay. In the Q&A pane as well. So we wanted to show you really the firstly as Berkay said, yeah, the video path is the best to showcase and also to demonstrate as well. But in parallel, of course, we are capable of receiving also from CMP probes, low speed probes, over also the GTK probe directly, all in parallel as well. Okay, all right. So thanks, Berkay. We have also one more thing. What I mentioned before and started teasering, we on our ADL will offer an AI-based smart logging solution where we will have a lot of intelligence inside our system, inside our ADL 1000. Where we can, in real time, in the vehicle, directly analyze video data and get out the interesting scenarios. So meaning we will offer very soon smart logging, smart triggering capabilities with pre-labeling functions and pre-notations as well for directly analyzing the interesting scenes and just only recording the interesting scenes. So stay tuned about that. More exciting news will come. So, okay, thank you from my side. First of all, thanks to the audience. I see that we have a lot of attendees here and a lot of attendees starting the session and ending the session with us. So that shows me really that it's a high interest, that topic. If you are interested to get more information about our joint solution from ETAS and PSD2, please do not hesitate to contact us directly. We are really happy to answer those and get into more detailed discussion with you about your project needs.
And maybe just one comment here from my side. So we started here this webinar with really a close look on the ADL1000. We mentioned several times that the complete solution is bigger, and so we are at the moment looking at providing also different information in other webinars. So please have a look, and you will find probably something in the near future which extends this scope of today. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.